Welcome back, Money Team. This is Mad Money Shot, sniffing at the Madden cheese as always. Got another offensive scheme for you today out of the Baltimore Ravens. And this one's a good one. Without a doubt, one of my favorite formations of Madden 22 so far. I first saw these plays back during the beta. I didn't really get to mess with them too much, but now that I have the full game, I mean, I think I've unlocked close to its full potential. This is going to be the middle high low of Madden 22 for me, this particular formation, because I know there's more to it. I haven't gotten it all yet, but I know there's more to this. This is one of the glitchiest formations in the game based off the fact that it's a new formation. I don't think Madden programmed the defense to be able to handle it very well, and that's one of the reasons I think it's one of the best ones. Now, the formation itself is called the Gun Empty Quads, and as you can see, there's four receivers on one side of the field, which I've never seen in a Madden game. I've never seen that in any game. I mean, that's just like, I guess it's a college type of formation, I guess. I really don't know. I mean, one of them's a tight end, but at the end of the day, I've never seen something that's so heavily loaded to one side. And like I said, I don't think that EA has really programmed the defensive well enough to stop this, because I'm averaging like 30, 40 points a game every time I run this formation. It's unbelievable how easy this formation is. So as far as the substitutions go, you just want to make sure you got a lot of speed out there. I typically, for some reason, there's times where I guess I should put in somebody a little bit better than that guy, but for some reason my mutt team, I had two tight ends here, so just make sure you have three receivers. I think it's best probably to take Watkins out and then move him over here, because all the work's going to be done on this side of the field with these three receivers and the tight end. So without a doubt, you want your best guys there. You definitely want fast guys there. You want the most speed possible there. As far as the plays go, I have a couple of plays, but my favorite without a doubt is the four verticals. You don't even need adjustments with this. That's how broken this is, and I'm just scoring hellacious touchdown bombs all game. I also really like the quarterback blast. I had a game that I thought I recorded. I don't know what happened. I don't know if I deleted it. I don't know if I forgot to hit the record button or what, because I have the reaction video, the face cam video, but I don't have the video where a guy that I was playing just wouldn't respect the quarterback blast. So I ran it like 13 times with Patrick Mahomes. I fumbled twice, but I still ran it a ton of times and had a ton of success. So let's go and let's just pick the four verticals. Let's start off with that. We'll start off with cover two, although like I said, I run it and it feels like I could just run against random and chuck it around. So let's do that first. Just to show you guys what I'm talking about, I don't even have to read the defense. That's how easy this play is to run. If you really want to run this play, like, you know, if you're not good at reading defenses, you can really just watch A to, if you just go from front to back, you can watch A to Y to RB to B and just throw it to the first one that you see has a lot of space, and you can run it just like that. So if you're not too good at reading defenses, you can do that. As you can see, this perfectly is just, it's just so well spread because of the full wide receivers, and there's just not enough defensive players over there. So we're just going to go ahead, we're going to run against random defenses. So I'm just going to go ahead and run it. Like I said, if I just go front to back, eventually somebody's going to get open. That was probably a cover three. That Y route was just streaking right over the center there. So if you're not good at reading defenses, this is a really good series of plays to run, because you don't really have to read the defenses. You can just start at the front and work your way back. Start the A route. If he gets open, take it. It's a very easy catch and run, a very easy drag type play. If that's not open, then you just make your way back to the Y route. If the Y route, I mean, honestly, that's going to be open 9 times out of 10. As you can see, he was right there. I probably could have caught and ran that a little bit better, but you can see he's open pretty much every play too. A lot of times I find myself running it like this because it's just so easy to read. Right here we got that RB route. Like I said, I threw it a little bit, maybe a little bit on time. I was going to say I thought I threw a little bit early, but I still made it in there, as that was probably a cover two. The mid read on cover two does a pretty good job of getting up the field when it comes to that particular play. And then you can see right here, I mean, I snuck it in there. That's right. So like I said, I mean, you can see there's just so much opportunity. It spreads so well. Let's go and let's run it play to play, formation to formation though. Against cover two, I've had a lot of success running it just like this. I feel like that mid read does a pretty good job, but if you throw it on timing, there's definitely opportunity right at the center of cover two. As you can see, Devin Duvernay is not even a great receiver and he gets right past it. You could also just put this A route on a streak though. You can pull that safety back and then you could basically just hit this B route outside, because he's running something that's not really a streak. It's kind of like a fade almost more than a streak. If you watch the pattern, you can see that he kind of bends to the outside. So all you really have to do is just, you know, pull that safety back, wait till he gets past that outside cornerback, and then I have a lot of success, a lot of throwing, whether I got popped. but you can see it's still a really big play. That's probably the biggest issue you run into is you don't necessarily have a ton of pass protection, and when you have a superstar like J.J. Watt bearing down on you, it makes it a little bit, T.J. Watt, when he's bearing down on you, it makes it a little bit difficult to get off some of these throws. But even the A-route, I mean, that guy, he can be open. If you have a fast enough tight end, he's open right over the middle. So cover two, there's a lot of area of opportunity to attack when it comes to just running it as is, or you can run it to the A-route and to the B-route, and you're just going to have success all over the field. Now, against cover three, I feel like there's a couple different ways to run this as well. For some reason, the Y route just gets open wide as you go over the middle there. I'm going to go to the replay just so I can show that, because this is something that just doesn't even make sense to me. If you watch this route right here, the second the play starts, he's just wide open. I mean, and he's got to be like 30 yards to the closest defender just running straight down the middle of the field. Now, a lot of times your opponent might take that away. That's probably going to be their best move. But if they do, I mean, there's only so many, defenders on the field. If he's taken away, typically this tight end is going to be wide open. So it's really up to them. But for some reason, this thing just gets super wide open the second the play starts. So I'm just going to run this a few more times. Like I said, that Y route is just money. He just cuts right in front of the safety every time. That's why you probably want your best receiver there. And if I didn't truck, I probably would have been gone there. That guy just missed me. But like I said, when I run this in gameplay, I don't know if I'll get a ton of touchdowns here, but when I run this in gameplay, I get a ton of touchdowns. And I'm just ripping right down the field. So that's one of the more explosive plays. My second favorite play is honestly the QB Blast. Like I said, I've run this play a ton of times. You really want to just, the second your opponent starts really spreading the field, coming out in like dime looks and stuff like that, anything where they come out really small, you just have to be able to switch over and make a pay. So let's go with random dime. This formation really puts the defense in a tough spot. You really have to make a choice. When it comes to your defensive selection, try to match the speed on the field. And not a lot of defenses do that. Really only dimes do that. So your opponent's probably going to come out in something like this. When they do that, it's the perfect opportunity to switch over to the QB Blast. The QB Blast is something that I ran like 14, 15 times in the game with Patrick Mahomes, of all people, who's not very fast. And I still had about 50 yards. I think I had a touchdown or two. And I also had, I think I had two fumbles, which is the downside. So if you're going to run with a quarterback, make sure that they have some mobile capabilities, because realistically, and I also slid a lot too, because once I started fumbling, I was like, how much do I really want to do this here? But if they don't respect the run, which typically people won't, because they have to choose a defense that has so many defensive backs, you always have these run plays in your back pocket. You always have the quarterback flash in your back pocket. I eventually will get a guy like Lamar Jackson. Like here, this is probably a look where I don't have to do that, but I could also try to go behind this this right tackle here. And you can see like there's so much opportunity. Like I said, I would definitely slide a lot. As you can see right there, I think we fumbled, but we got it back because I did fumble twice in that gameplay. It didn't cost me, but realistically you can fumble and it could be huge. One of the fumbles was inside the 10, which absolutely sucked. So like I said, if they don't respect the run, which most people won't because it's really hard to in a formation like this, make sure that you use this QB Blast. It can really be a game changer, and if you have a mobile quarterback especially. Yeah, that QB Blast is probably one of the cheesiest things. The last play I'm going to show is the wide receiver screen. Now, this is going to be something, once again, a little bit of a trick play. You're going to want to use this when your opponent comes out in anything, cover three, cover four. Cover four is probably one of the best defenses for this play. So if they come out in that, or like I said, a cover three, which is also one of the most popular, most run formations, is probably cover three. Then you're going to want to hit them with this. So against any off coverage, cover three, cover four, you're just going to want to throw it out quick to your wide receiver. Try to make sure you have your fastest guy there. I put Brown in that spot. But without a doubt, this is something that you can definitely, because your opponents, one guy I was playing, he was dropping everybody back, as far as he could, because he was just expecting me to bomb it up over and over. That's a perfect opportunity. If they start playing back, just throw it underneath. It's a super frustrating formation. Between this play, the quarterback blast, and obviously the verticals play, you can just really, it's almost like rocking a college offense, and it's just going to drive your opponent crazy. So I'm going to go ahead and end the video there. If you guys want to see more plays out of this, I'm probably going to revisit this after I've run it a million times, because it's my favorite formation to use online right now. So if you guys want to see an updated video once I find more loopholes and more wrinkles, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. Mush it out. Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my bids and more. Link in the description below. Thank you.
Thank you.